Who goes yonder?
It is I, sire, Richard of Nottingham.
Well, speak up, man. What is it?
News from the east, sire. The ruler has returned.
Hey, y'all. It's Coach in the Fight here. Got a bit of a random class. You know, we try to put up all of our classes associated with the scripture. We try to stay in the scripture and not get too far off. But we tend to jump around sometimes and so pull out random stuff. And this is seemingly random. However, it could possibly be the most important YouTube video you ever watch in your life. Could very well be. The Heavenly Father, we come to you today, Lord, asking that you will open up our communication pathways and open up our minds so that we may understand the messages that you are sending from heavenly places. In your Son's name we pray. Amen, and so be it. All right, look here at Revelation chapter 19, verse 12 through 14. We're coming out of the King James Version. And I'm just going to read here. Y'all follow along with me. Now, you clicked on the title, so you obviously know what it's going to end up being. But we're going to look here at verse 12. It says, "His eyes were as a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns. And he had a name written that no man knew, but he himself," right? So now we're going to break this down a little bit. We'll look at the other, two verses. But let's look right here. It's talking about the Messiah. It's talking about the second coming of the Messiah. It's describing him, at least his eyes are a flame of fire and on his head of many crowns. But what I want to draw your attention to right here is where he says, and he had a name written, but no man knew, but he himself. Okay, so where is his name written? You know, now, y'all bear with me in a little bit. This is all going to come make sense here in a minute. But everything that is written from the Father we find in the scripture, correct? So his name is written in the Word of God. Or where else would it be written? The heavenly tablets? Well, we don't know much about those. You know, we can't get to them or see them or know what they're, or even, you know, most of us don't even care about them yet. But the only thing place we can know to look for his name is in the scripture. But he says that no man knew, right? So no man knows that his name is written in the scripture. That's what it's saying there. His name is written in the scripture, but no man knew it. No man knew that his name, what his name is. But he himself, he's the only one who knew what his name was. But look at verse 13. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. So look at that verse 12. It's telling you that no man knew his name. But then come here, verse 13. He tells you that there is his name, the Word of God. His name is the Word of God. So then if you scratch your head one or two times, and then it starts to make sense. Yeah. He is actually the Word. We learn that, you know, in John chapter 1, verse 1. I don't have it written in front of me. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, or something like that. It was there written the whole time, but look how it says we never knew what it was. We didn't know it there in verse 12, but in verse 13, he's even telling us what it is, but we still don't really know, even though he told us there in 13. And why do I say that no one knows? Because we're waiting for the second coming, but who's actually looking for him to come in the form of the Word of God? No, we expected him to come on clouds. We expected him to come, you know, some people expect him to come on spaceships. Some people expect, people expect him to come a lot of different ways. Remember that the majority of the people on the planet will fall for the Antichrist, who is the man. So the majority of the people on the planet thinks he's coming back as a person. Whoever thought, or have you ever heard anybody says that he was coming back as the Word of God? That's why I say this may be the most important YouTube video that you ever see, because this may be the one that, you know, makes it dawn on you where to actually look for the Father. Maybe we should look for him in the Word of God. Maybe we should look for him in that form, not necessarily on a television or, you know, in outer space or, you know, up on a cloud or wherever. But maybe we should look for him in the Word of God. Okay, so we're waiting for the second coming of Christ. We're waiting for Christ to return. Nobody knows the day or the hour. We know that we got a lot of events that are supposed to take place before he actually shows up, but like the Antichrist, the mark of the beast, and a few wars and a couple of earthquakes and such. But we are expecting him to come back at some point. But who's expecting him to come in the form of the Word of God? So maybe that should be where we ought to look for him, in the Word of God. Okay? Well, I'm not going to hold you up any longer. For those who follow my channel, y'all know where this is going. So let me just jump over here and show you. What my old uncles used to say, I can show you better than I can tell you. Look at this. The Third Testament of the Bible. The Third Testament, right? Now you can get some information right here and try to find this thing on your own. It's just trying to give you the origins of it. I've only found a PDF version online, and I'm gonna tell you that it is spirit and truth. I'm gonna tell you that it is the Word of God, and all you have to do is read it if you are a scriptural reader. And that brings me to a point I was thinking about earlier. Don't let anybody tell you that no, this is not holy scripture. Because let me tell you who are the very, very first people that will tell you that. The people who have never read the other scripture. The same people that don't believe in the New Testament and or the Old Testament, they are the same people who do not believe in the apocryphal books. And they are the same people who are going to tell you not to believe that there is a third testament of the scripture. But you believe me, coaching the fight. I've been around the scripture for a long time. And I'm going to tell you, this right here is spirit and truth. Now, they got some little linky information right here. There's an ISBN number right there. What is it? 9925-968-0-5. If anybody wants to try to find it, and you, there's even a phone number down here to call Grand Graphica Mercurio. I guess that's San Antonio. I don't know. That might be. That's somewhere in Mexico. But this is the Third Testament. So that's what this is all about. Is bringing you guys to the attention that the Third Testament of the Bible is out. And just like when you go to the Old Testament and the New Testament, and you can hold that up and say that this is the Father, you can hold up this Third Testament and say that this is the trilogy. But now, but this makes up the trilogy. Let me talk on that for a moment. This is the trilogy. There's a lot of debate in the church about the trilogy, about the triune God, about their, the three in one. And, we tried some guy put together the scripture and, something else, that there were three gods. That there were three gods. Somebody else came back later and said, okay, if there are three gods, then it must be the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And people kind of roll with that for a long time until now, when we're in this age of information age, where people are able to look up, fact check you real quick. People are like, wait, but the Bible never says anything about no three gods. It never separates, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Those are, really one being there. So what's up with this three in one? What's up with this triune that the scripture does talk about? What is it? What is this Trinity? Here is the Trinity. We're talking about the Old Testament, the New Testament, and the Third Testament. I'm urged to say that you have to have all three of these scriptures. Okay, so how is this going to work? I'm telling you that the Father is found in the Scripture, a book that you could probably find on the shelf, but you go down to Barnes and Noble or wherever you could find this book, if you could find it, but you find this book and you open it up, and no, you're not going to see the Messiah's face in there. But what are you going to see? You're going to see truth. Remember, we're promised that he's going to come back in spirit and in truth. Well, this document is the truth half of it. This is the truth as in the knowledge that we need in order to understand him, in order to understand the spirit. So he's coming back in spirit as well, you know. But we have to understand how the spirit works, and it's quite complicated. I'm gonna say that, you know, I've been, you know, working with this thing now for 8, 9, 10 months, and it's quite complicated to think of the spiritual side. What you think?
Yeah, because we're so not used to thinking about the spirit side. We're so used to thinking, for instance, that the Messiah is coming down in flesh. And we're looking for him in flesh, and we can't wrap our minds around that he's not coming down in flesh. I think it's because we can't see it. I think it has a lot to do with that. Well, one, we were not brought up to think about spirit. Number two, we actually was brought up to think that spirit was evil, wicked, you know, with the fortune tellers and all those kind of say. And number three, we can't see it. So it makes it hard.
Yeah. So this scripture, this third testament of the Bible, thank you, Stacy. But the third testament of the Bible, what it's going to do is it's going to help us to know what to look for. She says we can't see it. Well, what are we supposed to be looking for? That could be the problem. We don't know what to look for. If we're looking for them up there on the clouds, and we go out there and, you know, we look seem to be, you know, just looking up in the air or whatever. You know, where should we be looking? And so in this document, we learn what to look for, what are the signs, what is it like to live in the kingdom of heaven that he has promised us. All right, so here's this document here is the truth part. So, and we'll use it to find the spirit part. Praise the Father. So what do we do with this information, this new document, this new, some people are going to call it a new Bible, but it's not. It's just like an addition to the Bible, just like the Apocrypha was, except this one is, I'm not going to dare say more important, but it is the third testament of the Bible. It is a whole new testament, you know. And so what do you do with it? Well, might I suggest first maybe read it, you know. Read the book for yourself. If you are a avid Bible reader, you know, you read it all the time, or you listen to it, or you maybe even study it all the time, then you will be able to hear the Father's voice talking through this document. Okay? And so next, after you read it or listen to it, like I said, there is a YouTube audio book over there that you can listen to. But after you do that, you can share it, share the book, you know, share it with others. You know, even if you don't read the Bible all the time, you maybe know somebody who do. You maybe work with somebody who, you know, talks about the scripture all the time, or maybe want to do a Bible study, or you may have a relative that, you know, always, you know, talking about the Bible this or did or the law that, or give them this book. All right, so what are the next things you could do is print it. Print the scripture. Print it out. Print this book out. You know, I haven't been able to find a hard copy of it. I haven't been able to even see it anywhere, any copy whatsoever, and except the PDF file, and so print it, you know. I've worked at these big corporations where, you know, they got these big, huge, you know, printer machines, you know, big as, you know, my mama's little car there. But hit the print button, you know, on accident, mistake or whatever, on purpose for accident, where you hit the print button and it's like, I don't know what happened. This document came out there. I thought I was, you know, printing one page, and I printed one copy, you know. You know what I'm saying? Replenish the paper, go to Walmart and get a ream of paper, you know, make the next coffee pot and be that on that. Then teach it. So another thing you could do is you could teach this. Right. There are a lot of spirit and truth in there. I mean, a lot of insight, and as far as life is concerned, as far as our personal health is concerned, as far as our spirit body is concerned, our spirit man is concerned. There's a lot of information in here that, if we share with, our families or maybe even our friends or whatever, it will go a long way to helping not only them, but it help us too. You learn more by teaching than you do by doing just about anything else. But before we go, let me give a little bit of my testimony regarding the Third Testament. Well, really, you have to go all the way back to about 1995 when I discovered the Holy Bible, the 66 books of the Bible. There in 1995, I was told to read the book of Proverbs. And thing about it, I got hooked and read from I read Proverbs, and then I read the whole New Testament, Matthew through Revelations. Then I came back later on and read Genesis through Revelations. And then I actually did it two more times back to back, three times in a row. I read the whole Bible, King James Version, until somebody helped introduce me to the apocryphal books, like the Lost Books of the Bible, Forgotten Books of Eden. Read that one twice before I went on to other books like the Dead Sea Scrolls and every other scriptural book I could find. Fast forward all the way up to 2018, we get to the Sabbath day right around in I'm gonna say January, February time frame, and my family and I are looking and discovering what's said there in Isaiah 58 about how the Sabbath days are to be, treated. And we looked at ourselves and we said, the blessings associated with this day as being described in Isaiah chapter 58, and what we're seeing in our life, and our attitude toward the Sabbath day and what we're seeing in our life, both of them aren't lining up. And so we decided to experiment a little bit with the Sabbath day, and it was, I would say within a week, the Father led me to the Third Testament of the Bible. He led me to the book online, to YouTube. I basically typed in 144000, and I got a whole bunch of hits on stuff that I had never heard before. I didn't know anything about the 144,000, nothing whatsoever, except they were supposed to be virgins or whatever. And so, but the thing about it was, all of these scriptures that they were talking about, at least a lot of these scriptures that they were referencing, I didn't know where they I didn't know anything about them. I didn't know I hadn't heard them. It seems like I heard them before, but I couldn't, I didn't know where they were. So I immediately started looking. Of course, I went to the online and went to the King James Version and looked and looked, and nothing quick, and not in. And then I went to the books on the shelf, and we have the Pseudepigrapha up there. We have, a bunch of books up there, on that shelf, scriptural texts, and it wasn't in there. And so, praise the Lord, I prayed and asked him, to show me where this book was. And almost immediately, it was like, copy and paste. So I copied and pasted it into Google, the words from the text. I think I had to type it. I couldn't copy and paste. I actually had to type it out. And so I had to type the word, hit the pause button on the YouTube page, and hit the pause button on the watch page, and typed out the words that were displayed on the screen, and the verse word for word, and it popped up. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, who is this guy? I ain't never heard of coaching the fight. He ain't even T.D. Jakes' little nephew or nobody. Who is this guy to come on here and tell us about the Third Testament? Well, tell us about a new Bible. Shouldn't it be the Pope telling us about the new scripture, or shouldn't it be, you know, some other very important guy, maybe the president, or you know, the minister of some foreign country? At least, you know, you need somebody. But no, we find out that no, it's not going to be the bigger guys that's going to, you know, tell us about the Third Testament. Well, the second coming of the Messiah is going to be the little guys. Look right here. Now, this is an excerpt. This is actually coming out of chapter 60. It's called Work in Accord with the Spirit of Christ. If you look right here, verse 89, it says, "You who have received this revelation are the ones indicated to announce to humanity my new manifestation through human understanding." Now, this is what we were talking about earlier about share this document. That's what it's telling you here, that, you know, that you who are receiving it are the ones who were chosen. It's no accident that you're here on this website hearing about this. There's no accident at all. And then when you look around, other than me and you, nobody else really knows about this thing. So it's like I'm giving you a huge treasure, you know, for free. You know what I'm saying? Just a little bit of information. It didn't cost me anything. But think about it. My wife did the calculation. We did a little made-up little calculation the other night, last night, and said that, you know, it's probably 1 in a million people in the world that actually know that this Bible exists. 1 in a million. So what do you do with it? You share it, all right? But let's see right here. Let's see what it says. He says, but he's saying that it's up to you to announce this to humanity. All right, but look right here. It says, who would you wish to testify if you do not? So if you don't go tell everybody about this book, who is going to tell them? Right? The Reverend Pastor Deacon Dr. Doug, or, you know, T.D. Jakes, or Kenneth Copeland, or the Pope? Verse 90 says, if you wait for the princes or the ministers of religions to take this good news to humanity, you are in error. For I tell you truly that although they see me, they will not open their mouths to say to humanity, there is Christ, go to him. So the princes and the ministers, they're not going to tell you. Who are the princes? If you remember in the Old Testament, you know, it was a lot of people were kings, and they could imagine there was a lot of princes around. So this is talking about like the bloodline Israelites, because there's a lot of people who still claiming this royalty based on blood ties to Israel. So you have those people, which would be considered Jews or Jewish, or, you know, that kind of group. And then you have the church group, which would be like your, you know, reverend, pastors, deacons, you know, and such. And so we're saying neither one of them is going to bring it. Neither one of them is going to tell you. So it's going to be the lowly guy to do it. So here you are, probably a, you know, lowly guy. I mean, the sophisticated guys, you know, they would have clicked off long time ago, because our editing team is not, you know, been hired yet. So there you have it, guys. The Father has returned. It's not necessarily in the wilderness or in the desert. However, we learned in the Third Testament that he's both in the wilderness and in the desert and in this room with me right now and in the room with you too. That's what we learn in this document here. We learn about the Spirit and how it all works. So let's get it, guys. Let's read it. Let's study it. Let's start a Bible study. Let's start something. Let's get some knowledge around this thing. There's only a few of us that know about it. Let's form some type of, you know, some type of community here. I don't know. So we definitely need each other's support as we, you know, battle against the materialistic world that's going to try to, you know, say that their Father ain't coming that way. He's coming in some, you know, something that we can see. We have to stand up for it. So let's stick together, guys. If you got something out of the video, or if you got something out of the Third Testament, leave a comment down in the bottom. Leave a little testimony for everybody to see. You know, if it touched your heart, the Third Testament touched your heart, let everybody know you found it. If you find another copy, or if you find another translation, or if you find a hard copy in a store anywhere or anything, just let's put it in the comments, guys. Let's make this the little community service on the Third Testament so we can, you know, get as much knowledge and information as we can. All right, guys, I'm going to close out there. Subscribe to the channel. Hit the thumbs up button and pray for us.
As if you're still living, and get on down to the old slick river. Now this one here is called the ruler, my dear. It's a mere party booster that'll set things clear. It's 100% proof of champions of truth. And if you feel you need spirit, I'll bring back your youth. Relax your mind and folks unwind, and be kind to a rhythm that you hardly find. And off we go, let the trumpets blow. Well, hold on, because the driver of the mission is a pro. The ruler's back.
Hermes Academy. Power, patience, continence, and faith. We teach virtue.